Ang nangyari sa itong mga Lopez of companies. Ang Congress is planning to restore the franchise of the Lopez. Wala akong problema doon kung i-restore ninyo. But if you say that if they can operate, kung may ano na sila, no, I will not allow them. I will not allow the NTC to grant them the permit to operate. Kung ibigay ninyo yung franchise because it is within your power to do it, go ahead. Alam mo bakit? Unless and until babayaran ng mga Lopez ang taxes nila, I will ignore your franchise and I will not give them the license to operate.
Ang tanong ko sa liderato ng ating Kongreso, hindi ko na ho babanggitin ang pangalan dahil sabi ni Congressman Herrera, huwag mo na sabihin ang pangalan ni Speaker Lord Velasco. Ano ang aksyon na ating gagawin tungkol sa investigasyon na ito? Yes, thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, gusto ko lang pong magsalita ukol doon sa pananalita ng ating Pangulo, ang talumpati niya kagabi. At dito po ay na-involve ang ating Kongreso na sa aking pong palagay, meron pong kolektibang apekto sa ating reputasyon at integridad bilang mababang kumpulungan ng ating Republika. If I may proceed, Madam Speaker. Let me just quote Section 105 before I begin, Mr. Speaker. Questions of privilege. Questions of privilege are urgent matters directly and principally affecting the duties, conduct, rights, privileges, dignity, integrity, or reputation of the House or of its members individually or collectively. Nabanggit ko po, Mr. Speaker, noong ako'y nagpaalam sa ating kagalang-galang na Majority Floor Leader na ako po'y tumatayo on a question of personal and collective privilege. Sa kadahilanan na ang Pangulo po ay nagsalita kagabi tungkol sa investigasyon na isinasagawa sa Development Bank of the Philippines na kung saan binanggit niya na nagkaroon ng suspension at if I may quote him directly, sabi niya, hindi maganda para sa atin yan. Mr. Speaker, the President also stated that there are many investigations of banks but in this particular case, when we were about to investigate the Lopez loan, we suspended the investigation. At idinugtong niya, Mr. Speaker, na ito daw po ay ibibigay niya na sa Ombudsman. Now, Mr. Speaker, let me begin by saying that I already spoke with the Honorable Aglipay, who is here with us in plenary, the Chairman of the Committee on Good Government. At nagpapasalamat po ako, Mr. Speaker, dahil ngayon po nagkaroon kami ng paglilinaw kung ano ang tatahakin at direksyon ng Committee ng Good Government at ng ating Kongreso. Importante, Mr. Speaker, yung sinabi ng ating Presidente at kung ano ang aksyon na gagawin ng ating Kongreso ukol sa investigasyon na ito. Dahil ang ating reputasyon, ang ating integridad, ang ating pong panunungkulan, our duties and responsibilities here in Congress, in particular, the Committee on Good Government, has to pursue the investigations until its final conclusion. Malinaw po yan. Pagka po nagkaroon ng paghinto, ito ay didesisyonan ng komite. It is the committee's decision. I'd like to thank the Honorable Aglipay again, Mr. Speaker, during the break. Nilapitan niya po ako at nagkaroon na po kami ng paglilinaw. Because, Mr. Speaker, what happened was, in January 18, nagkaroon kami ng investigasyon. Doon po sa aming pag-uusap, sinabi ng Bangko Sentral ng Pilipinas na yung mga loan na to ay walang eligibility. Yung po ang nauna. Ang pangalawa po, ang sinabi po nila ay walang mga dokumento at nawawala na daw. Ang hindi alam ng Development Bank of the Philippines, eh meron po tayong hawak ng mga dokumento. Dahil ang issue po na ito ay lumabas na isang dekadang nakaraan. No less than the columnist Neil Cruz of the Philippine Daily Inquirer, God bless his soul, wrote about this issue of condoned loans of the ABS-CBN Lopez Group. And Mr. Speaker, it was in fact the very statement of President Duterte that there are condoned loans. And during that hearing, Banko Sentral ng Pilipinas was affirming that there were loans not given eligibility. Ngayon, Mr. Speaker, kung ito namang depensa nila, sinasabi nila na ito daw po ay pwede silang magbenta kahit hindi tumahan sa SPAV dahil ito naman po daw ay tax incentive, lalo pong mas masama dahil yung 10 na bilyon na utang, ginawa po nilang 3 bilyon. Mr. Speaker, I see the face of the Honorable, the beautiful face of the Honorable Herrera. She requested me not to dwell on the issue, but I'm just stating a fact na meron pong patutunguhan ang isyong to. May mga dokumento at may mga ebidensya. At ang Pangulo na nga mismo, nagsabi 3 taong nakaraan, binanggit niya na to. Kagabi, nagalit na siya sa Kongreso. Bakit natin hinto at ibibigay sa Ombudsman? Ang tanong ko, Mr. Speaker, ano ang ating gagawin? Ang tanong ko, sa liderato ng ating Kongreso, hindi ko na ho babanggitin ang pangalan dahil sabi ni Congressman Herrera, huwag mo na sabihin ang pangalan ni Speaker Lord Velasco. Ano ang aksyon na ating gagawin tungkol sa investigasyon na ito? Mr. Speaker, again, I thank the Honorable Aglipay. I understand there will be a hearing on the 17th. Sana po ay matapos natin to. Because Mr. Speaker, in the end, ang talumpati ng ating Pangulo was on the vaccination. And he mentioned that the payment for vaccination will come from loans. Ito po ay panggagaling sa utang. At ang utang na yan, manggagaling sa DBP at sa World Bank. Ang pera po ng DBP ay pera ng taong bayan. Yan po ay pera ng gobyerno. At responsibilidad ng Kongresong to na hindi payagan maulit-muli ang pagkawala ng pondong yan. Dahil yan po ay hindi natin pera, hindi perang privado, kundi pera ng sambayanang Pilipino. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and good afternoon to everyone.
Representative Mike Aglipay is hereby recognized. Please proceed.
Mr. Speaker, thank you. Honorable Mike Defensor, maraming salamat sa iyong talumpati. Nung kami po ay nag-hearing ng January 18, napagkasunduan po sa mga resource persons na binigyan sila ng taning na isang buwan na i-produce po yung mga dokumento na kulang. Yung Lopez Group po, DBP at saka BSP. Yung taning po na yon ay sa Feb 18 pa, kaya ang hearing po natin ay sinuspend ko nung Feb 3, 2. Nung Feb 3 po, natawagan po tayo ni Speaker and in instruction niya tayo, biski hindi pa Feb 18, is mag-hearing na. Yung utos po na yon nung Feb 3 ay sabi ko, Speaker, kailangan po kahit konting oras mabigyan natin kasi 15 years ago pa po itong mga papeles na to. So napagkasunduan pa namin nung Feb 3 and in-instructionan ko po yung COMSEC na i-prepare ang hearing sa Feb 17. So yun po ang napagkasunduan ng lahat at ito po ay pending sa Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability. Rest assured po ay hanapin natin yung punot dulo nitong issue na to. Maraming salamat po.
The distinguished Deputy Speaker is hereby recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I just like to react because my name was being mentioned. I was looking at the Honorable Defensor because this topic is already a topic in the committee already for deliberation. And hindi po tama that he's using the time here in plenary to discuss things that are up for investigation in the Committee on Good Government. Kaya ko po siya tinitignan para pigilan po siya dahil hindi po tama na dinidiscuss po natin ang bagay na to, ang subject matter na to, and he gave us his assurance earlier that he will not violate the rules of this floor of the plenary para po magkaroon ng due advantage doon sa kanyang posisyon. Kaya Mr. Speaker, I just like to put that in record. That's why, that is the reason why I was looking at him to prevent him from saying anything further regarding the subject matter that is already a topic in the Committee on Good Government. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The distinguished deputy speaker, see by recognized, please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. We would like to be enlightened as to what is the purpose of these deliberations going on now on the floor to take over the time that we would want to allot to tackle very important measures pending for this body. Ano po ba ang punot dulo nito? At ano po ba ang karapatan ni Congressman Defensor na tumayo upang questionin ang nangyayari sa committee. Nagbago na po ba tayo na rules? He is mentioning a collective privilege. I do not feel belonging to that issue. That issue is not my concern, and I'd like to be dissociated from his position. And I'm questioning his citing collective privilege when this issue is a very personal one for him. Mabuti pa sinabi niya, personal privilege, and I will respect that. Pero collective, I do not feel belonging to what is cited here. He is citing again his personal crusade against the ABS and the Lopez companies. Ako po'y nakadalo sa isang pulong na ginaganap base po sa kanilang reklamo, chaired by Congressman Mike Aglipay, and I listened to the deliberations and the opportunities given him to support their allegations. And I personally witnessed failure on their part to support their allegations with documents. And I support whatever action the chairman would take to handle these particular issues, because when one goes to any committee for an investigation, he should be ready with documents and not go on a fishing expedition requiring the banks, including the central bank, to bring the documents that they are required to present before the body, before the council, the committee. At this point, bringing the issue on the floor occupies all of our time, and I question that particular action because this is not in accordance with our rules.
Mr. Speaker, before the reply, my name was mentioned, and I'd like to react on the statement of the Honorable Agenza, Mr. Speaker.
The distinguished gentleman from Anak Kalusugan is hereby recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, isa-isayin ko, ang unang binanggit po ni Honorable Agenza, yung daw salita ko is not a collective privilege. It is precisely a collective privilege, Mr. Speaker, dahil ang Pangulo nagsabi, Kongreso.
That is so not that my is point, Mr. Speaker, and I have a motion, Mr. Speaker.
No, before the motion, just quick. Now, on a personal level, Mr. Speaker, I did say it is a personal and collective privilege. Ngayon, Mr. Speaker, sinasabi ni Honorable Belmonte, I already touched on the issue. Mr. Speaker, I never discussed pro or against the issue. Ang sinasabi ko lang yung factual na mayroong mga lumabas doon sa ginawa naming hearing. Therefore, yun ang kinagalit ng Pangulo. Now, if you feel that the President had no right to say that mali ang pag-suspend natin, okay, delete what I said. That there was condonation, that there was suspension, because that is the statement of the President. And if the majority will allow that those phrases will be taken off, then I would say that this very Congress is fighting the objective and intent of the President. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you, gentleman from Anak Kalusugan, the Majority Floor Leader.
Mr. Speaker, there is a pending motion.
I object, Mr. Speaker. I object. So we vote on it.
There is a motion. Will the distinguished gentleman from Quezon City please repeat his motion?
Mr. Speaker, this representation believes we should not vote on a question of rules. This is a rule written in our book of rules governing this particular Congress. And the gentleman from Anak Kalusugan is citing a subject which is already being taken up in a committee. So what's the basis for taking it up? So therefore I support the suggestion, motion of Congressman Belmonte to dispense with this discussion. Otherwise, we will concentrate the whole afternoon today on this issue.
With the indulgence of everybody, will the distinguished gentleman from Quezon City please repeat his motion?
Mr. Speaker?
Yes, please.
Mr. Speaker, I move that the statements of the Honorable Gentleman from Anak Kalusugan, which pertain to subject matters already being tackled by a relevant committee of the House, be stricken from the records of this plenary session.
Majority Floor Leader.
I object, Mr. Speaker.
Majority Floor Leader.
Mr. Speaker, before the good gentleman, Honorable Defensor, can make an objection, this representation for the majority joins the Honorable Kit Belmonte and move to strike the statements pertaining to those related matters as mentioned by the Honorable Belmonte. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, I formally move to strike out those statements.
Mr. Speaker, if I may state my objection.
Is there any objection to the motion of the distinguished gentleman from Quezon City?
I object, Mr. Speaker, and if I may state my objection.
Mr. Speaker, there is a pending motion.
The objection of the distinguished gentleman from Anak, Kalusugan party list may have been out of line. And so, basing it on the rules, provisions of the rules, the chair upholds the motion of the distinguished gentleman from Quezon City. The majority floor leader.
Mr. Speaker, I appeal the ruling of the...
Thank you for upholding the rules.
Mr. Speaker, I appeal the ruling of the chair precisely because I'm not arguing...
Mr. Speaker, I move to suspend session.
Session suspended. Session resumed.
Mr. Speaker, majority floor leader. Mr. Speaker, I would like to make it clear to the gentleman from Anak, Kalusugan that we are striking out not the entire speech, but those subject matters that are only subject of the deliberation in the committee. I would like to assure the good gentleman that we are moving, what we move for the striking out of the statements are those statements that pertains only to the subject matter that is being deliberated now by the committee.